Hello guys, this is Biker 21 here and this is the usual Mumbai traffic. I'm finding my way through the traffic to reach home as soon as possible. And the traffic is getting worse day by day. And I have stopped using the Western Express Highway because it's not the Express Highway anymore. We cannot call it an Express Highway anymore. It's packed with all vehicles, bikes and everything. And there's the metro construction that's taking place on the highway. So most of the road is covered with the construction material and they have started building pillars everywhere. So I ditched that road a long time ago. Now I use the RA Colony Road and that's a beautiful road. Not much traffic there. It cuts through the forest and weather's quite pleasant over there. It feels so good over there that I don't use the highway anymore. So anyways, secondly, I have the new front tire on my bike. It's the MRF Masseter's and I got it for around 1700 rupees. With installation, there was no extra charges for that. Now I'm not sure what's the price elsewhere, but I got it for 1700 rupees. Maybe you guys can get it for cheaper price, as such as like 1500 rupees or so, 1600 rupees. No matter how much discount you get, discount is always good. So this is what I got it for, 1700 rupees in Mumbai. The tire is amazing tire. The grip is amazing. Since it's a new tire, it's supposed to be amazing, but the thing is, my earlier tire, the stock tire, I think they were the MRF revs. The profile was 90-80, so I mean that was the dimension of the tire. So 90 was the width and 80 mm was the profile. So opposed to that, now what we have is 80-90. So 80 mm is the width and 90 mm is the profile of the tire. So the tire looks quite round now. It's not so flat. It looks quite round. Okay, where am I? I think I'm on the wrong side of the road. Anyways, so this is the metro that goes towards Andheri Highway. I mean the Western Express Highway and then further into Andheri Station. I'm taking the RA Colony Road as I said before. So coming back to the MRF tires. This tire is good. Actually, my stock tire ran about 30,000 kilometers. It's 30,000 kilometers now, 30,887. So I changed that tire at around 30,100 kilometers. It ran pretty much good. I should have changed it some more time ago. Now, secondly, I didn't change my rear tire because my rear tire was changed at 25,000 kilometers. What happened is my rear tire was giving me a lot of troubles. It was getting punctured every day. There was some issue with that, and as you have seen, if you haven't seen my video of the 7 punctures that I got, do check out this link. It's appearing on the screen on the right corner, so do check that out. It's a video that I recorded like more than 2 years ago, which I uploaded this year, I guess. And I mean, I uploaded that in 2016. So that's what happened with me. Actually, there was just one puncture and I was scammed for 7. So I ended up paying 700 rupees for no reason. But later I discovered the tire was useless. It had worn out completely and I replaced it with a Michelin street radial, I guess. Yeah, Michelin street radial. And the dimensions are 150 by 60. So I know it's quite weird that how did the 150 section even fit onto the R15 version 2. But there's nothing strange about this. The tire fits well. It has given me better grip, better than the stock ones. So I was saying, okay, my stock tire was 130 by 70, and instead of getting a 140 by 70 for the rear tire, I got 150 by 60. It's the same size that fits on the KTM Duke or the RC models. So that's what I chose. I researched a bit and I also asked a few tire wallas, and they also told me that there have been a few people who have got the 150 by 60 on their R15 version 2. And I researched a bit and I realized that the rear tire would look even rounder. It will have a rounder profile because of the increase in width, and the profile was decreased by 10 mm. It will result in a round tire surface, and trust me, that's true. It did give me a good it did give a good profile and better grip. So that's what happened. I changed my rear tire back then And the thing is, I know it's wrong, it's not the right way to change tires. We are supposed to change both the tires at the same time. But back then I was too confused with everything, and being scammed earlier, I just thought I should just go and replace the rear tire first. And now, since my tire was quite old, it had a lot of cracks and tire was literally flat. I mean, I'm talking about the front tire. Tire was literally a bit towards the flatter side. It wasn't so round anymore. So finally I got fed up of everything and I got it replaced, and it's working amazing. And after getting this particular tire with this change in profile and width, my bike is running amazing now and I'm getting good grip. So right now I'm going to the towards the RA Colony Road, and I'll show you how this, I mean, I'll tell you how this tire is performing. There are a few corners and twisties, so just wait for it. In some time we'll be in RA Colony, and that's where you will see how my bike performs. Like, I'm too confident about the tire now. I can lean my bike further than I usually do, in control environments of course. And so let's see what's up ahead. The traffic that you're seeing right now is quite acceptable. It's not bad at all. It's quite acceptable. I can live with this amount of traffic even on the highways, because you can imagine how worse the highway condition would be. So what happens is, the RA road, it connects Goregaon and Powai. So it's a link between those two places. And there's one shortcut that leads to this road. It's the Marol Maroshi road, it's what they call it. That's the name of the road. So I use that road and reach directly to Goregaon, and that helps me a lot. Sorry. Should have let them go first. Oh bhaiya. Amazing, man. You didn't even indicate. Or maybe I was on the left side of the road. I was far on the left. So this keeps happening. So the tire is good. It's holding well. My bike is, it feels like I have a new bike, completely new bike. Because the flat profile, the earlier flat surface of the bike, it was restricting me from leaning or bending or anything. So now, since the surface is rounder, my bike performs well. It's good. It steers well. It leans well. Everything is well, since it's a new tire and that's how it's supposed to work. So here it is, the main road, the main RA road, the right side. The road leads towards Powai, and on this side it goes to Goregaon. So this is where I'm headed now. I use the same road in the morning time when I'm going to office from home. I think 1 kilometer, and I'll take a shortcut. Now that shortcut will help me bypass some more traffic. This sort of traffic that we're seeing right now, this is fast moving. Even though it's fast moving, but there are too many vehicles and you cannot overtake anyone. It's a single lane road and the road is not so wide, so there's a bypass a few hundred meters or a kilometer ahead. Now that will take me through the core forest area, and that road is pleasant as well. There are a few corners, there are a few places, there are a few points on road where you can actually try your cornering skills, even though it's not recommended. But you can still, because that's what I do. I have been using that road for quite some time now, and I have been, you know, testing myself, testing the tire. I'm taking some good leans, at least further than I usually do, like I said before. And they have also begun with reconstruction of this road. They have started repairing this road, I think during the night time they dig it out. Now this road is not recommended during night times or even late evening. It's pitch dark. The only light available is the lights from vehicles, so it's not recommended. There have been quite some stories about this road that, you know, the people have been abducted, or I don't know, carjacked or any other things. So let's not focus on that now. I'll focus on my ride. It's 6 o'clock. By this time the highway is full jammed up. So this is it. This is the left turn that I was talking about. Now, one thing to remember about this road is there should be no car ahead of you, or it will just screw up with your cornering skills. So I'll overtake this one and the one that's ahead. So there used to be a pond over here, but it's all dried out. Now this road is not so wide, and usually so that's what happens. So fun begins over here. This is the road I was talking about. It's quite good. There are some bumps and speed breakers ahead. Just have to take care of it. Just have to pay attention on the road and the road signs. So this car is going to cause some trouble for me, because there's an amazing corner ahead. Oh, and I missed that. So this is it. This is what I'm talking about. There are a few corners. They're not so fine as they're supposed to be, like in MotoGP and all, but they're doable, they're quite doable. I just love this road. It's so pleasant at any time of the day. It's so pleasant, and it's dangerous at the same time, during the night time actually. Oh, this is the blind spot over here. And the best thing about this road, there are a lot of dogs, and yet none of them bark at you. So that's an amazing thing, because that's not what happens on the busy streets of Mumbai, or any other street of Mumbai, or any other city, or any other country. Because dogs usually bark, stray dogs, they always bark at you, especially when your bike sounds a bit louder than usual. So RA Colony, what it is, for people who don't know what this is, it's basically for cattle grazing and all the milk products and dairy products. So this is the business they are into. There are buffaloes everywhere and cows, and they, you know, it's all in the milk business, or other dairy products as well. So that's what happens in RA Colony. That's what they do. And there are a few hostels, I guess, and some fertilizer industry, I think. I'm not sure about that, but that's how it is. And this road is quite amazing. This is one of the oldest roads in Mumbai that used to connect Goregaon, like the Western Express Highway, and the Powai area. So this is one of the oldest road in my knowledge, as per my knowledge. And then there came the Jogeshwari Vikrori Link Road, that's the JVLR, which is a shorter road, wider road, and much preferred road by everyone else. But since I cannot take that road that does not lead me to my office, I use this road. So for first timers, you need to learn this road first. When I was here for the first time, I misjudged a lot of blind spots and a few speed breakers. I even hit a lot of speed breakers earlier, but now I'm used to it. Now all I have to take care is the blind spots and the traffic coming from the opposite side. That's it. So here you can see the hay. Hay is what they call this grass. That's what I learned in school. So this is the dry grass, which is also called as hay. That's what they feed the buffaloes or the cows or any other cattle. And this is one old building. What I'm planning is one day I'll come along with my brother, bring both the bikes, the Duke and the Avant 5, and place it somewhere and shoot some good photos, because I think it will produce amazing photos over here. So that's what I'm planning. There are a few bridges and few spots deep within this place, deep within the jungle, which is not restricted, or I wouldn't be trespassing any one of them. But there are some good spots where you can actually shoot some good photos. A few abandoned houses and a few old structures. and vegetation, it will look amazing. So that's what I'm planning sometime in future. I would do that. I'll see if any of the motor vlogger, any of my friend tags along with me, because I would love to do it with someone else as well. So another thing that I recommend is when you are riding from this road, if in case you use this road, your visor should always be down. It should always be down, because there are many insects and everything that, you know, you cut through them and they just happen to enter your eye. So it has happened with me once, and every day after traveling from this road, I noticed there are some bugs and insects splashed across my visor. So that's what happens. So that's the end of it. I'll be out on the main road again, and the traffic has started building up. Since it's an exit to the highway, there will be some traffic because there's a signal over here. So anyways, I'm out of this RA road now, and what you see ahead is the Western Express Highway, and I'll show you why it's not an express highway anymore. So this is it. I'm back into the concrete jungle. I have covered more than half of the distance of my journey towards home from office, which is 15 kilometers long. It's not much, it's just 15 kilometers, but it takes me more than an hour to reach home to cover this distance. And if you compare this with any other Sunday or a Saturday, you'll reach home, or all I can say is you guys can cover that amount of distance of 15 kilometers in just 20 minutes, 20 to 25 minutes tops. So it takes thrice the time on a normal working day. So that's it guys, I'll be home in around 20 minutes. So if you like this vlog, do hit that like button, do subscribe for more, and do check my other videos as well. So until then, see ya!